Welcome to Uniti Update,
episode 28.
We are in England again, and this time we're staying in London.
And as Robin said, the idea is to have an event.
And the agenda for this event is simply to explain a bit more to the UK crowd, meet some investors, and announce the crowdfunding campaign for real.
Which we're also going to explain to your viewers while we show you more from our tour we have done in Sweden.
Yeah, how are you feeling?
Good.
Good. It is the morning of the event. We're the first squad to arrive here. It's 20 past 7, so we got to set everything up. It's here in one piece.
Fantastic.
Nay, the modern beams.
We should have had this trailer when we took this car from Lund.
This is like a Formula One trailer.
Jack Lamborghini.
It does pass for Formula One cars.
What do you think of the car?
I like the car. It looks like it's something like the movies. I'm a bird watcher. So this is also an electric vehicle. So we're all in the future right now.
Oh, that's cool. And they said it's the first week to have it in London.
They go really fast. So these electric scooters are parked all over this campus. So how Uniti fits into this is it's a type-built vehicle for this ecosystem. So you can take a scooter if you're going short distances.
For these mid-sized trips, Uniti is perfect.
And then when you're going further, you can take the train or you can rent a car.
It's a great example of mobility as a service where you have the vehicle somewhere, you log into it, you use it for the time you need, and then you leave it. Same could be done for Uniti.
And that's how you get clean mobility in cities. Lighter, yeah. More efficient.
And fun. Yeah, it's great to be able to enjoy a great city like London without contributing to all the noise pollution and the air pollution.
To Maryland, yeah.
We are introducing London to the Uniti. Almost speechless, it's exciting.
I said I've watched all your crazy videos and loved every one of them, so here you are, great. In the flesh.
It's interesting, thank you.
It looks like it has a lot of space.
The color is great. It's exciting.
Oh, it looks brilliant,
yeah, it looks
honestly.
It's very slick, isn't it?
I would buy one, because I live near a city and this would be perfect for the city.
Yeah.
That would be my dream. To get away from petrols.
Oh, you've seen our videos.
I like the ones where you're talking about what's happening in terms of development.
And of course, we would like to include some of that in this episode as well. And here at our event is Martin.
He is one of our battery engineers from Danecca. So we took the opportunity to let him explain how our battery is built.
It is an extremely classic configuration. Exactly the same cell format as, for example, the Model 3. Which definitely keeps cost and provides volume. The module construction at this stage is using 21700 cells. It's 8 modules in the battery pack. Per module, there's 192 cells for a voltage of about 48 volts. Our idea with the battery is essentially to give you a week of urban driving before you need to fully recharge it. You will be able to find a service center locally that doesn't necessarily need the craziest protection devices to operate on the battery. The chemistry is a fairly classic lithium-ion. The big partner we have, Itosho, which is a big Japanese supply company, and they really put a lot of weight to make sure that when we put a green sticker or a happy face on the cell, it's not just a sticker, we've actually done the ethical work of checking where it comes from. The other big important thing is, after we've done all these awesome cars in the next 5 years, we need to be very clear on the recycling processes. It's just we need to do the work as battery suppliers, as automotive makers, of securing that.
So we hope that gave you a good insight into our battery pack.
And when you use this battery, of course you need somewhere to charge it.
And as you might know already, we are partnering with E.ON and they were at our London event as well.
So we already have a relationship with E.ON in Sweden and we're looking to bring the blueprint of what we've created in the Nordics here into the UK.
I work in the fleet department for Lidl.
We have our own fleet, hundreds of vehicles, and we are looking to renew it to adapt to new times.
And why are you here today?
Well, I guess that's quite clearly why.
So I'm Robert Hoken. I'm managing partner of Greenbackers Investment Capital, and we raise funds for low carbon, clean tech, climate change related companies, perhaps such as Uniti. So we've been looking at them with respect to their next round of funding. We're fans. like the approach, like the concept. It's great to see this vehicle to manufacture. You don't necessarily have to own everything. And that filters down to the users of the program. Don't necessarily have to own it to drive it. Uniti is going to have to prove itself in the marketplace. It's a competitive space, but the fact of the matter is peak oil in 7 years, Uniti's challenge is going to be to stand out, to have a service offering that is compelling. It's not necessarily all about price, but if they can hit those aspects of their program, if they can get it right, if they can get their brand out, if they can start delivering units faster, I think they've got a real chance to make a difference in this marketplace.
And do you see a larger trend within the investment community to put more investments into greener technology?
Definitely, definitely. I mean, we're not called greenbackers for no reason. We're seeing more funds looking at it. We're seeing impact investors starting to focus on low carbon and climate. You know, EVs are the future. It's got to happen. So it's got my vote.
It kicks ass, yeah.
I'd like to become a delivery center, a service center to provide a wider spread of Uniti cars across the country. These can we help?
Well, I first saw Lewis at a Siemens event and I was struck by the fact that Lewis is actually a more level-headed Elon Musk. He's got the drive and the vision. I love to see that in somebody who's actually responsible for something which is incredibly important.
We're ready to welcome you into the salt.
We can create a factory in any country you want to in the world. We are creating global supply chain partners, working with people like Unipart, to make sure that whatever we do, we can supply in the market that wants this solution. That's where our production gets sensible.
And I was a seafloor geochemist. I went from BP to PricewaterhouseCoopers, the global leader of their climate change practice. And I woke up one day and I said, I've never ever actually made anything. And so I started looking at this problem. I put together a team of people and we said, the future is about a small, lightweight vehicle for urban use. We scour the planet and we find Uniti Sweden AB. It will be virtually impossible to achieve the economic growth targets in this country in the absence of a rapid shift away from the existing ownership model of heavy internal combustion vehicles. This is the single most important thing I have done in my life. That's why I'm the chairman of this company.
Purpose built for the era of mobility as a service where people don't need to buy cars anymore. As you guys know, the digital world is a borderless world. This makes us, I wouldn't say Brexit proof, but it makes us very much Brexit friendly. Our operational model is designed for localized assembly around the world. For those group here that are the crowdfunding group, you get to see this video before everybody else.
Get to know our team and make a pledge as your way to become part of the solution. It's time to get the world where it needs to be. So let's get to work.
So if you want to see this whole video and the crowdfunding campaign and get more information on the investment opportunity, go to crowdcube.com/Uniti. Lewis is just about to do a YouTube show. What is it called?
Startup Daily Afternoon Chat Show for Entrepreneurs goes live 1 p.m. on Facebook Live every single day.
Document absolutely everything. Yeah. He was even talking about if he could go back to even Steve Jobs, yeah. If he had documented everything from the very beginning, the big goal.
So these guys here, from day one, is entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
From day one, just film everything, tell the story as you see it. Raw and authentic.
Please.
I was great. It was really good. The team did well. The crowd was very engaged. It was a wonderful event.
Lots of investors, porters, fantastic turnout.
And after London, we also did a tour in Sweden.
So, our journey continues and now we are in Stockholm where we are displaying our car with Deloitte. So it's really great here and we'll give Florian a couple of words.
We're working together with Deloitte on the mobility as a service offering to understand a little bit what does the market demand, what can we offer, and how do we best fit into the market.
We do a lot of things for Uniti. We love to collaborate with Uniti, look into the future, how will the mobility look like. So with Uniti, we've been working as advisors, talking about how will the different business models look like, how will the strategy look like, and how will people use this type of vehicle in the future.
So now we're done here in Stockholm at SmartCities, and now we've driven all the way to Gothenburg, and here we're going to eCarExpo.
And we were actually at the eCarExpo already in 2016. And then it was in a tiny venue and hardly anyone knew about Uniti.
However, now that electric cars really have gotten to the masses, everybody recognizes Uniti in an event and it's really great.
And the event is now in one of Scandinavia's largest event venues, and that's a great sign for the EV industry at large.
And another sign that electric cars are really taking off is this electric bus behind us.
You can see charging here from the top.
And of course, this one, it's an autonomous pod that drives around Chalmers University here in Gothenburg.
So we're actually in an autonomous vehicle being driven around Chalmers by a computer.
That's pretty cool.
So while at the venue, there was an incredible variety and endless examples of electric vehicles.
Like this one.
And 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 the half of this one.
And this one.
And this one.
That one.
And of course these ones.
And this one.
And this one.
And this one.
This one. And this one.
And then there is
this one.
This is Volvo's new concept car.
The Volvo 360C.
So it's their concept and vision of what the future is. It's a lot bigger than the Uniti, but it has the similar design language and it's a really pretty car.
And inside it you can actually lie down or rest while you're being driven to your location.
And it's really cool to see it in the flesh. Yeah, good on Volvo. I don't even know what this is. It's a Hummer, but it's tiny and it's electric.
Hummer's having a bit of an identity crisis.
Yeah.
So, remember Hummer? You know, the big diesel guzzling super large van truck thing?
It was actually GM, and now they're licensing the brand. And now they're making tiny electric cars, apparently.
My name is Isaac, and this is my ride.
There was a lot of other stuff going on as well.
Like two podcasts covering electromobility and of course our booth with E.ON.
We're really grateful for this partnership because it really shows that we're stronger together. Startups and big industrial players.
So once again, a big shout out to E.ON for a good collaboration.
And before we leave you this episode, we wanted to let you know that our crowdfunding campaign is ending soon.
So make sure you stop by our campaign page and check out our business plan as well as all the uniquely created content.
The link is crowdcube.com/unity, so go check that out.
Wow, thank you for this episode, see you next time.
Remember to like, comment, share and subscribe. You'll find another Unity update out soon. Stay tuned.